How's it going, everyone? Tyler House here with In-House Performance. Welcome to my first YouTube video. I know I've been hinting about making a video on my social media accounts for the last couple months, so I finally had some time in my busy schedule to knock out a video for you guys. So thanks for being patient with me, and I'm glad you guys joined the channel. Many of you may know me from my Instagram, and some may know me from the car scene in Arizona. And also, many of you may know me from my interview with N54 magazine and KP. A lot of stuff's been done to the car since then, so I figured I'd just kind of fill everybody in that doesn't know about the car and some of the stuff that's done. So, as many of you know, this is a pure Stage 2 car right now. And we're actually, there's some news that'll be released in the next couple weeks. That's gonna change, and I'm really excited to show you guys, and I'll be doing a video on that. So we'll start with the car. As you guys can see, this is my 2015 BMW 535i. I've had this car for about 4 years now. I've been working on building it, and I guess we'll start with the mod list, starting with the front of the car, and we'll start with the performance aspect of it. So as you guys can see, there's not many F10s around with a front mount intake system. The M5 does have this setup. I'm currently in development with an in-house performance front mount intake system, and we're in the prototype phases, so some of this work is temporary and will be changed in the future. So as you can see, here is the piping that's going to the turbo, and then to the inlet of the turbo, and then from that we go to the G Plus front mount intercooler. Now I know it's a Chinese knockoff. I waited a long time for VRSF to come out with theirs, and I just got impatient. It's literally identical to the Wagner and to the VRSF step-down front-mount intercooler. Performs the same, looks the same, and so for a quarter of the price, you can't really go wrong. I got mine on Amazon, and I'm really happy with it. Going from there, we come up with some more FTP intercooler piping. You can get that stuff on Keys Motorsports. FTP makes a whole slew of stuff for the F10 M55. So go check that stuff out at keysmotorsports.com. From there, we have the VRSF charge pipe. Now, if anybody owns an N55, you know this is the weak spot on your car. Before you do any modifications to the car, I highly recommend getting a charge pipe replacement. Like I said, FTP has one, and then VRSF, and there's multiple other companies that have them. So definitely recommend that. From the VRSF charge pipe, we go to the Evolution of Speed intake manifold. Now, I went with this intake manifold for a couple different reasons. One, I have their EKP module, so I've been really happy with the quality of their product and how it performs. And two, I wanted an alternative solution for fueling in the sense of methanol injection. If you want to run port injection, they offer this fuel rail setup here to put injectors to run port injection on this manifold. And then on the bottom side, which I'll attach some pictures, they offer threaded bungs on the intake runners so that you can run port meth injection. I do have port meth injection on this car, and as you can also see, I have a meth injection system on my charge pipe. So with that being said, we have additional fueling going to the car, and we're also able to cool the intake air system. Your IATs are key to the performance of the car, and with BMW, as everybody knows, if your intake air temperature is over 100, 110 degrees, your car will start to pull timing to help prevent knock, and that obviously decreases your power. I live here in Arizona, and in Arizona, it gets really hot during the summer, so methanol injection really helps keep the performance of the car running smoothly. So with the additional fueling, I have a total of 1,000 cc's of jets on my intake runners for my direct port meth injection system, and then I have another 500 cc's going into the charge pipe for my intake air temperatures. So my meth system is run by an AEM electronics, and I'll kind of give you guys a walkthrough on how it's set up on my car. So in the car,
in this one compartment, this is where I have it set up. You can't really see the lighting, but there's my AEM controller. Just makes it really quick and accessible. So I have it just slid in there with my arm light.
So with the ease of accessibility there, I'm able to change the dials on the meth injection system. It's obviously controlled by boost, so I can change where I want my meth to start spraying and the full spray. When you come back here, this is where the stealth tank is. Berger Motorsports has a 2-gallon stealth tank that mounts right here by your battery. This is the cleanest application I've seen. And then you have the mount on the bottom side of the tank for the AEM methanol pump. As you guys can see here, that is my Evolution of Speed EKP module. They have a BPM4, which is their fuel pump control module. It replaces your factory EKP. And now that we're kind of talking about that, I'll go over my fuel system. So on this car, I have two separate tunes. I have an E50 tune and I have an E85 tune. With those two setups, I had to replace pretty much the entire fuel system with the Pure Stage 2. You can run pretty much all the way up to E30 on the stock low pressure fuel pump, but once you start to get above E30, you need to start replacing, starting with your low pressure fuel pump. I went with the Walbro 525. It's a great pump. A lot of performance shops and companies use it on their cars. And so that was the first thing that I replaced on my fuel system. But when you do that, the Walbro 525 requires more current than your actual stock low pressure fuel pump. What controls that low pressure fuel pump from your ECU is your EKP module. Now, the stock EKP module operates between about 8 to 10 amps. And these Walbro 525s require like 15 to 20 amps. So you're naturally gonna have to replace your EKP module if you go with a fuel pump like this. I believe they do offer some other fuel pumps, but the main issue is ethanol. Ethanol is less efficient and requires more work from the pump. Therefore, you're gonna have higher current needed to operate the pump correctly. So you're gonna need an EKP module once you start to get into the E50 and E85 systems. From there, I have a hard fuel line obviously running down my frame rail, and then it goes to, I have an inline 10 micron aeromotive fuel filter, and then followed by my Fuelit Bluetooth ethanol content reader. Obviously, since I have two separate tunes, it's good to be able to determine or see what ethanol content I actually have in my fuel line. So from there, we'll go to the front of the car again, and then I will try to show you my door stage 2 high pressure fuel pump. There she is. And so I chose to do this method of fueling. It's super simple and easy to install. You just have to take off your intake and it goes in the exact same spot as your factory high pressure fuel pump. It looks identical to your factory high pressure fuel pump. So they provide all the lines. You don't need to cut, bend, or do anything like that. So great addition and a lot less going on. When you run port injection, you have to run a separate controller like a JB4. You have to have injectors that can fail or clog or go bad. So that was why I went with that, because for a while this car was my daily driver. So since we're talking about fueling and the performance of the car, I have to give a big ups to Kerry Jordan and his team over there, Jordan Tunes. Those guys are rock stars. Kerry is a rock star. He's been with me for the last 2 years tuning this car, and I couldn't be more happy with the service, with his tuning. Again, big thanks and big ups to the guys over at Jordan Tunes and Kerry Jordan for everything they've done for us and for me in this car, and it's really appreciated. I do have, you can't really see down this way, but I went ahead and designed and built my own downpipe. Now, this is not something that I'm planning on producing or selling in the future. I just did it for the fun of it. We took the stock downpipe off and I went ahead and did catless TIG welded downpipe that went back to pretty much the stock exhaust system. I have the mid resonator still in place, and then I just did a muffler delete with dual exhaust out. I'll kind of show you guys that, give you a walk around here. So there's the quad exhaust tips out, and then we have an M5 style diffuser out back
with the quad exhaust tips.
So now that we're done with the performance aspects of the car, I wanted to talk about one of the number one questions I get on my social media account, and it's in regards to my wheel and tire spec. As many of you know, I have variant wheels on my car. My good friend Taylor and Rob, both are owners of Variant, and they helped me set this car up exactly how I wanted it to look. I really couldn't be any more happy with how they turned out. So let's go ahead and just highlight these wheels real quick. So these are the Variant Argon brushed aluminum wheels. To get this concave look on the front, we went with a 20 by 10 wide front wheel. This is obviously not an off-the-shelf spec. These were custom made. So just know if you go to your local dealer or anybody else to get wheels, unless they custom make or forge or machine their own wheels, you're not gonna get this spec. Currently the front tire, I have Continentals, and this is I believe they're the Extreme Contact Sports. Yep. And this is a 255 3020. And then we go to the rear, and this is a 20 by 11. And now currently on this tire, I am running Continental's new Extreme Contact Sport 2. And this is a 305, as you guys can see, 305 3020. I am static right now, and I have plenty of room here. So I'm pretty sure we can tuck a 315 under here, but we started with the 305. I haven't seen many F10 chassis with a 305 tucked underneath there, especially with my stance. So really, really happy with how these tires came out and how this wheel and tire setup worked out on this car. And I think it just complements the car. I had black wheels on the car before, and this just changed the whole look of the car, made it a lot more classy looking. I'm obviously a big tuner fan, and this kind of gave me the VIP vibe of that culture. So really happy with how these turned out and how they look, and really, really thankful for those guys over at Variant for hooking me up. From there, suspension wise you can't see up in there, but I have the BC race coilovers. They were a cheap option. I'm working with another company right now to actually put this car on air. I love riding around static, and it gives you a different credibility, but it is a pain in the ass. So with that being said, we're working with a company that's developed a performance strut that goes with the bag, so hopefully we'll have that. So once we get those, I'll actually do another video on me installing them and putting them on this car. But for now, yes, currently I am static, and that's the setup on this car. So another addition that I made to the front suspension and rear suspension was a set of iBox sway bars. Now, for about $600, you can get these sway bars, and I highly recommend everybody get these for their car. If you climb under the rear of your F10 and you see the dinky, tiny little sway bar that you have in the rear, it is almost a joke. It does not prevent body roll. It does not help stiffen the chassis. It is the most useless looking thing I've ever seen under this car. But with, thankfully, from iBock, with a cheap solution, they offer a really, really good kit for sway bars. Let me see if I can get you guys a video of what it looks like. So now you can see I have this beefy sway bar for the rear, and we also got it for the front. This has definitely stiffened up my chassis, and the ride on cornering and turns at high speeds. So I definitely recommend the iVox sway bars. They help really change the performance and driving of this car. She's a big girl. With me in the car at the track, I think we weighed 4180. So those iVox sway bars definitely help stiffen up the chassis with cornering and body roll. So definitely get yourself a set of sway bars for this car. Other than that, we can cover some of the outside aesthetics. As many people know, this is the F90 front conversion. I get a lot of questions about this front bumper, and the problem is I don't know the name of the company I bought it from. It was on eBay. They didn't have any reviews, and so I just went ahead and purchased, and it turned out great. The fit and finish is actually really, really good. As you can see, all the lines match really, really well. It looks really clean. I think this is a big game changer for the front end look of this car. But one of the big issues I had with switching over to this front bumper was trying to pick out a front splitter or diffuser. Because this is a replica, the aftermarket splitters and diffusers don't fit. So we went with this splitter from Aerodynamics, and it is an aluminum, I think it's about 1/8 inch aluminum. And this thing looks good, completes the front end look of the car, but it also is a beast. I've had a lot of carbon diffusers, splitters, stuff like that on my other front bumper. I tried a couple different ones on this one that didn't fit very well. Big ups to the guys over at Aerodynamics. This is actually an M4 front splitter that I put on this car, and it fits great. So for anybody that's been asking about what splitter this is, for what bumper this is, it is an Aerodynamics M4 front splitter. Other than that, everything's pretty much, I mean, we have the limo tint, we have, I actually have the headlights tinted. My buddy owns a company called Cruise Armor, and they actually do helmet and like pretty much anything helmet visor or motorcycle visor wise, even goggles. And what this is it's similar to PPF, and it's got a self-healing technology. So he hooked it up and got those wrapped for me, and I think it made a really, really good look on the car. So if you guys are interested, check out Cruise Armor. Mostly do helmets, but my buddy Brent over there is the man, so really appreciate him helping me change the look of this car. All right, so I pulled my car outside for some better lighting because I wanted to show you guys what was going on with the interior. Now, obviously, I don't have a whole lot going on with the interior right now, but I wanted to show you this amazing steering wheel I got from Zeus Steering Wheels. They contacted me and helped me build pretty much my dream steering wheel. Now, obviously, as you can see, it's a matte forged carbon. And it's got the Alcantara hand grips with the red stitching, and then the matte forged carbon centerpiece. It also has an LED display up here, real quick. So it's got the logo and then the RPM indicators with, there's a few different options that pop up when the car's on to go from like RPM to coolant and oil temperature and stuff like that. And it's really simple because it goes to the Bluetooth OBD port. So really, really happy with how this turned out. I think it looks fantastic and kind of gave me the idea of what I'll be doing in the future with the interior. We're gonna do some matte forged carbon trim panels throughout, and then there'll be a seat change as well. And then in the back, it's all still just the black on black, but we're probably gonna remove these back seats, and I'm going to cage the back and then also do a display centerpiece here for the air ride system. So definitely excited for all that. So that's about it. That covers everything that's kind of done to the car, inside, outside, performance-wise. Really happy with how the car is performing right now. Like I said, my next video I'm gonna do is my dyno days, and then I'll be posting some of my logs and some of my horsepower numbers that I got with the car so far. But we're going to have a big announcement here in the next 2 weeks. So definitely stay tuned to that. We're going to be doing some big changes to the power, and really, really excited to show you guys what we got going on. So thanks again for joining the channel. Like, subscribe if you like the content and you're looking forward to seeing what's going on with the build. Also, if you guys have any questions or comments, anything like that, feel free to leave them in the comment section. I'll happily answer them the best I can. So thanks again for joining, guys, and hope you guys have a great day.